morning, let us know the importance of education and few study tips and examination tips to be followed. Why education is important? Education makes you elegant. It adds color and richness to your life. It's like a passport to the future, which can provide plenty of golden opportunities. If you are a well-educated seed, you can flourish as a fruitful tree anywhere in the world. This is the reason why all the parents and teachers emphasize the importance of education, which can take you to the higher level in the life. Let us know a few tips that can be followed while studying or preparing for the examination. Initially, we need to make a study plan. It is also called as a blueprint of plan of action. For example, we need to take our complete syllabus and time that we have in our hand. For example, if we have a 20 chapters or 20 units, how many we can plan for a week? Around 5. Then once we have a weekly plan, then we can plan it for daily routine. So excluding the hours for our daily activities, rest and sleep and other activities, remaining at least some 10 hours or 10 to 15 hours. Then how we can plan? That can be planned according to subject wise or daily plan. Then overconfidence is always risky. Commonly what the students will be thinking, we have plenty of time so that we can study just before the examination. This is always risk taking. If we have a well-prepared plan, nothing is impossible. So it is called as everything is piece of cake. That means if I have a proper plan, hard work, then nothing is impossible and everything can be done in a simple manner. That is called everything is a piece of cake. It is an idiom. Practice makes man perfect. This proverb everybody knows that once we keep on practicing, for example, maths formulas we don't understand. Once we practice for 10 or 15 times, everything can be perfect. Study with concentration. Whatever we do, that should be done with concentration, not with the like parents are complaining or somebody is telling to study. It is not the reason. Even if you study for half an hour or 1 hour, we have to study with concentration that can reach our mind. Learn with passion but not with compulsion. What is passion? Passion means we have a strong interest or desire, we can say. So whatever we learn with interest, that can be always fruitful, but not with compulsion. Compulsion means force. So we cannot go with anybody's force. Make a chart or timetable and paste it in your study room. So once the syllabus and everything is planned, once the blueprint is ready, then we can just prepare the timetable. Maths, these many hours. Physics, these many hours. Or biology. So that the timetable can be pasted in front of our eyes where we are studying. So that we, by seeing that, we can study, and our parents also can remind us, oh, this is time to study, or have you completed these lessons? So this will take you to the proper planning and makes you to study well. Set digital reminders or paste some wall reminders. So sometimes we may forget, or sometimes we may sleep for few hours. So when we have this alarm in the clock, definitely we can wake up and we can plan for our study. Don't depend only on prescribed textbooks. So your school will be prescribing some others or some textbooks. So it is not good to prepare only textbook. It is better to always go with other books also. For example, a student is studying in Chaitanya. He can take other books, other like Narayana or other schools, and just you can remind once, so that they can be knowing even more points. This is always a good habit. Newspaper reading improves the reading skills. When we go with newspaper reading, definitely we can improve our vocabulary, means new words we will be knowing. And we will be studying with the pictures. So when we see with pictures, definitely we can remember those incidents. For example, general knowledge or current affairs. They can be remain for long hours. So we won't forget what we study in the paper. Structure your thoughts based on the doubts and questions. So sometimes we'll be getting some doubts or queries when we are studying some content. So once we get doubt, we should be clarified and we have to come to a conclusion that, oh, this is the answer for this, or this formula is explained in this way. In this manner, first we have to convert this into our own thoughts. Be an early bird. What does it mean? Means we have to wake up early in the morning, around 6 or 6:30 or at least before 7. So even an half an hour time can make you much difference. For example, if you get up at half an hour late, what will happen? Everything will be done in a hurry manner. So going to a washroom or brushing your teeth, taking breakfast, everything will mess up and they will make you confused. So you will do all the things in a hurry manner, which will makes you confused. Know your potential and ignore your weak points. What is potential? Means our strong points, our strengths. So, for example, you can study late hours, or a person can study in the early morning. So, just a person can study in the open air. A person can study only in a single room where nobody can be there. So, where you can do, what you can do, know your strengths or your points so that you can plan it in a well-fledged manner and you forget your weak points. Take running notes while studying or reading. Taking running notes is always helpful. For example, one time writing is equal to 10 time reading. So what we write is always remembered for a longer time. Don't copy as it is from the textbook. So we have to put it in your own words. So don't copy from the textbook as it is. Try to use audio visual tools, that is online teaching. Nowadays we have plenty of videos available online. By seeing those, you can remember the content in a well manner. Try to have hand-on experience, because practical learning is always an asset. Why have practicals in our school? Because when we do things with our hands, that can be remind, or we can remember well. So the practical hours are very important along with the theory hours. Never deviate from study plan. When we are studying, we'll be having plenty of distractions. So for example, TV, or when we study from online, there will be plenty of videos coming. So we should not deviate from the study and go on back of them. In between breaks are essential for better learning. So continuous studying is not at all advised. So in between, you can go for outside, or just you can wash your face and you can refresh your mind. For this, listening to the music and listening to the comedy videos also helpful. They will refresh your mind. Prepare flashcards or charts. For example, we have some important dates or wars in history. When we arrange those in a chart form, they can be remembered well and it is very easy to understand when they are in the order. Try to arrange some topics in diagrams or flowcharts. For instance, life cycle of a tadpole or frog or any plants. If we have that in diagram form, it is easy to understand and write the well in exam. Manage time in a wise manner. Time is always precious. So we should not neglect the time. It should be utilized in a proper manner. Physical exercise improves the psychological health. Physical exercise is always helpful for maintaining health of our health and also our brain's health. Sleeping for 7 to 8 hours is always good for health. We need to have a nutritious diet. We should include all the major and minor elements, that is fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, and so on. Along with this, practicing yoga is also essential, which can make you confident and also you can pay the concentration. Be optimistic rather than pessimistic. So we should be always hopeful, think positive, and leave the negative thoughts. Self-evaluation or testing yourself. So once we prepare for exam, we need to take various mock tests or quiz, and we can ask our parents or elder sister brother to give some test so that we can test ourselves. This is always helpful and to know where we are. Start with easy topics. While learning about the subject or preparing for the examination, first we have to always go with the known topics. Which topics are easy for us? That topic should be studied first. Leave some space between the two answers. Even in the notes or in the exam paper, if we leave some space between two answers, then we can add some points when we refer some other books, or if we get some points there, those can be added. If nothing is there, simply we can draw a line in between those two answers. Failures should be the stepping stones for the success. So once you get the less marks, or if you leave the question, any answer in the exam, don't get depressed. So you have to practice it, and you can plan it in a better way for the final examinations. Learning is continuous throughout our life. So learning is never a single step, or it is contained to a single phase. It is always continuous throughout the life. We can learn plenty of things. Knowledge is divine, which makes you wise. The person who is having enough knowledge or content will have always respect in the society. Work is worship, and hard work is always an excellence. So keep hard, keep on working, and you can get succeed in the life. Leave procrastination. What is procrastination? Postponing things or laziness. So if we leave that, we can succeed well in the life. Thank you.